Hello everyone. So last class we were discussing problems on continuous beams by Kani's method. So we have solved different types of problems on continuous beam where we have considered the last supports both as fixed and also last support is simple support and also with overhang portion. Okay. So let us solve one more problem on continuous beam where the settlement of support is given and also rotation of support is given. If you see this particular problem, so it is having three spans, A, B, C, D, A to B one span, B to C one more span, and C to D one more span. On AB span, 30 kiloton per meter UDL is acting. On BC span, there is a triangular load, that is symmetrical triangular load of intensity 50 kiloton per meter. And on CD span, there is a concentrated load of 100 kN acting at the center. Okay. So again, in this problem, they have given support B. This support is sinks by 8 mm. Nothing but it is having a settlement of 8 mm. Then support D, that is last support, fixed support, it is rotated by 0.002 radians anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So this support is rotating anticlockwise and support B is having a settlement of 8 mm downwards. Okay. So then again, they have given the values, that is Young's modulus 210 GPa and moment of inertia 0.1 giga mm raised to 4. Okay. So always remember when you come across the problems with the settlement of supports or rotation of a support. So you need to take care of this with respect to fixed end moments. Okay. So due to this settlement or due to rotation of support, there will be additional moments developed. Okay. Those additional moments will be added to the fixed end moments. So due to load, how you will be calculating the fixed end moment? So with the formula, so as usual, you calculate, then add the additional moments developed due to settlement of supports or rotation of supports. Always remember, due to settlement and due to rotation of support, there will be additional moments developed. Okay. So let us see this problem. So one more thing. So whenever they give the settlement of support or rotation of support, so we require the Young's modulus and moment of inertia. That is ultimately the product of Young's modulus and moment of inertia is called as flexural rigidity. We require the flexural rigidity to calculate the fixed end moments. So they need to give us the values, Young's modulus and moment of inertia. So or else in the examination, if the question is with respect to Young's modulus and moment of inertia, you need to understand this is a problem where settlement of support is given or the rotation of support is given. Okay. So Young's modulus, it should be always in standard unit, that is kilonewton meter square, and moment of inertia, it should be in meter raised to 4. If I write the flexural rigidity, the standard unit is kilonewton meter square. So always convert before starting the problem, the flexural rigidity in this standard unit, that is kilonewton meter square. Young's modulus, that should be in kilonewton per meter square, moment of inertia in meter raised to 4. So ultimately the product, so it will be kilonewton meter square. Okay. So let me convert that first. Yeah, here Young's modulus is given 210 GPa. So giga Pascal. So kilo means 10 raised to 3, mega means 10 raised to 6, and giga means 10 raised to 9. 210 into 10 raised to 9 Pascal. What is Pascal? That is Newton per meter square. This is Newton per meter square. Similarly here, 0.1 giga again 10 raised to 9 mm raised to 4. So now the standard unit for E is we need to convert in terms of kilonewton per meter square. So now you are converting Newton to kilonewton. So 1 kilonewton is equal to 1000 Newton. So whenever you are converting from higher to lower, you will be multiplying. Whenever you are converting from lower to higher, you will be dividing. So now here you are converting from Newton to kilonewton. So lower to higher, you will be dividing, correct? So I will be writing 210 into 10 raised to 9 divided by 10 raised to 3. That is Newton to kilonewton. So similarly, meter square is there. It is as usual. So standard is there. So if you simplify this, it is 210 into 10 raised to 6. Here 3. Here 6 is remaining. Okay. 210 into 10 power 6 kilonewton meter square. Similarly, moment of inertia. So again, you are converting from lower to higher. So millimeter to meter. 1 meter is equal to 1000 mm. So you are converting from lower to higher. Again, divide. So that is 10 raised to 3. Okay. It is raised to 4. So 10 raised to 3 raised to 4. So ultimately it is 0.1 into 10 raised to 9. 10 raised to 4 threes are 12. Now it is in meter raised to 4. Now if you multiply these two, so let me write it here. EI is equal to 210 into 10 power 6 into 0.1. So this is 12, here 9. So remaining is minus 3. 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 3. So EI. So ultimately 10 raised to 3 is remaining. 210 into 0.1. It is 21 into 10 raised to 3 kilonewton meter square. Okay, or else you can write it as 21,000 kilonewton meter square. Okay, this is the flexural rigidity. So what we need to consider while calculating fixed end moments? 21,000 kilonewton meter square. Okay, so once you are ready with this Young's modulus and moment of inertia, ultimately EI in standard units. So then let us start with our usual procedure. So that is step one, you need to find the fixed end moments. So let me take this rotation of support and settlement of support. Also into consideration, let me draw the figure after this deflection and rotation of support. So support A is not having any settlement as it is. Support B is having a settlement of 8 mm. So this is 8 mm. Support C is having zero settlement, and support D, it is rotating anti-clockwise. Earlier it was here, now it is anti-clockwise. This is 0.002 radians anti-clockwise. Okay, so now this is the deflected shape of the beam. This is support A, B, C, and this is D. Now after settlement of support and rotation of support, so the beam looks like this. Okay, so whenever you come across the settlement, so you need to calculate the relative settlement in the span. So support A is not having any settlement, support B is having a settlement. So what is the relative settlement in this span? That is 8 minus 0, that is 8 mm. It is rotating clockwise. So I will be considering plus 8 mm. Okay. So similarly here in BC span relative settlement, so B is having 8 mm, C is having 0. It is rotating anti-clockwise. So settlement in BC span is again 8 mm. But the rotation is, since it is anticlockwise, I'll be considering as minus 8 mm. Okay, so here the values are given in meters, but Settlementine is mm. So convert this into meters. So 8 mm divided by 1000, nothing but 0.008 meters. So here also it is 0.008 meters anticlockwise. Okay, so now here there is no settlement. This span will not experience anything, but there is a rotation. So due to rotation, again additional moment. So here let us solve step number one. You will be finding the fixed end moments. So MFAB. So due to the load, what is the fixed end moment? Plus due to settlement, plus due to rotation. So ultimately, the fixed end moments developed will be due to load, plus due to settlement, plus due to rotation. So due to settlement and due to rotation, these are additional moments. These are additional moments due to settlement and due to rotation. So MFAB, so A to B due to load. Load is 30 kiloton per meter UDL. So it is minus WL square by 12 as usual. This is due to load plus due to settlement. So always remember, whenever you come across a settlement, the additional moment developed will be minus 6 EI delta by L square. So I hope you are aware about this, since you have already gone through the slope deflection method, correct? So additional moment developed here, it will be minus 6 EI delta by L square always. Okay, then plus due to rotation. So here AB span, it is not having any rotation. The rotation is directly D span. So here it is not having any rotation. For AB span, I am writing for AB span. So due to rotation, the additional moment will be zero, since there is no rotation of A or B. Only settlement is there for AB span. So I will take care here. So if you substitute the values, minus 30 into 4 square divided by 12 minus 6 EI. EI, just now we have calculated 21,000 into delta. In AB span, the delta, it is having the rotation clockwise. So I will be considering plus, that is 0.008 meters. So L, that is 4 meters. Since I am substituting everything in meters, I have converted the delta also in meters, 0.008. It is plus, since the AB span is rotating clockwise. Okay, so if you simplify this, due to rotation, it is 0. You will be getting minus 103.0 kilonewton meter. Minus 103.0 kilonewton meter. Okay, this is MFAB, minus 103.0 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MFBA. So let me rub this. MFBA for ABBA in the same span due to load. Now it is due to UDL plus WL square by 12. Due to settlement, always minus 6 EI delta by L square. Then due to rotation, the AB span is not having any rotation. Either A support is not rotating or B support is not rotating. So again, if you substitute the values, so W is 30, L is 4 meters divided by 12, minus 6, EI is 21,000 into delta is 0.008. Again, L square is 4 square. Okay, so delta, again I will be substituting 0.008. Whether you find MFAB or MFBA, the settlement is in the same span, AB or BA. You need to consider plus 0.008 only. Okay. So in earlier problem, this was also minus, but here it will be plus due to load. So ultimately, if you solve this, you will be getting minus 23 kilonewton meter. This is MFBA. Okay. So next, MFBC. MFBC, B to C, a symmetrical triangular load. So the fixed moment, that is pi WL square by 96, the formula. Then plus settlement. So again, BC span is having a settlement. So I'll be writing minus 6 here delta by L square. Then plus due to rotation, the support B and C, they are not experiencing any rotation of support. So due to rotation, additional moment will be zero. Due to settlement, it is there. BC span. So whether you calculate MFBC or MFCB. Okay, let me write MFCB also. Due to load, it is 5 WL square by 96. Due to settlement, minus 6 AI delta by L square. Due to rotation, it is zero. Okay. So delta, you will be substituting minus 0.008. Here also you will be substituting minus 0.008. So BC span, whether you calculate MFBC or MFCB, ultimately it is minus 0.008. So that you need to substitute. Then W here, it is 50. Then L is 5. Similarly, EI is 21,000. So once you substitute this, if you simplify, you will be getting minus 24.78, minus 24.78 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MFCB is 105.42 kilonewton meter. MFBC minus 24.78, MFCB, that is 105.42. Okay, so once you get this, then last span, that is CD. Now MFCD, due to load, a concentrated load acting at the center, WL by 8, then due to settlement, minus 6 A delta by L square. So again, the slope deflection equation, when you come across the rotation, so near end and far end will come into picture. Okay. So here the rotation is applied, that is near end. Due to this near end, even the beam or the span will move here also rotate. So that is far end. This far end will also experience a rotation. Correct. This is near end. This is far end. The moment developed at near end and far end. So near end, it will be 4 EI theta by L, and far end, it will be 2 EI theta by L. So here D will be the near end, since the rotation is given here. Due to this, even far end will experience a moment, that is 2 EI theta by L, that is at C. Now you are calculating MFCD, that is C to D. So means this is far end and this is near end. So at far end, you are writing at far end. So additional moment developed will be 2 EI theta by L. So if I substitute the values, so minus 100 into L is 4 divided by 8, minus 6 EI delta. So for CD span, CD span, delta is not there. So ultimately, you'll be getting zero. So plus 2 EI, EI is 21,000 into theta. Here the theta is anti-clockwise. So if I draw the figure, you are applying the rotation here. So anti-clockwise. So the beam may deflect like this, correct? So similarly, here also moment developed. So that deflection will be something like this. Okay, here also anti-clockwise movement will develop. Here also anti-clockwise movement is applied. So here also at the far end, same direction movement will be developing. So that is this. Okay, that is anti-clockwise. So since it is anti-clockwise, the rotation is given in anti-clockwise direction. So here also anti-clockwise direction. Theta I will be considering minus 0.002. Why minus? Since it is anti-clockwise. So here also the additional moment developed, the rotation will be considered anti-clockwise only. So now if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 71 kilonewton meter. Okay, so I forgot to write L. L is 4 meters. Okay, so 2 EI theta by L. Simplify this, you will be getting minus 71 kilonewton meter. Okay, similarly for MF DC. Okay, similarly for MF DC, that is from D to C. Due to load plus WL by 8. So due to settlement minus 6 I delta by L square, but however there is no settlement in the CD span, so it will be 0. And due to rotation, okay, so now this will be the near end. So at near end, additional moment developed will be 4 EI theta by L. So again, theta now here you need to substitute as again 0.002 since it is anti-clockwise minus. So let me again do this. 100 into L is 4 divided by 8. This is 0 plus 4 into 21,000 EI into theta minus 0.002 divided by L is 4. If you simplify this, you're getting only 8 kilonewton meter. You will be getting 8 kilonewton meter. Okay. So this is how you will be calculating the friction moments if settlement of supports or rotation of supports are given. So always remember, due to settlement or rotation, there will be additional moments developed. If it is settlement, additional moment will be minus 6 EI delta by L square always. The span, if it is rotating clockwise, plus if it is rotating anti-clockwise, minus. Similarly, at near end, additional moment developed will be, if rotation is given, then 4 EI theta by L. At the far end, it will be 2 EI theta by L. Okay. So once you find this fixed end moments, then step 2. So rest of the procedure is same like previous problem. So let me go through those steps quickly. Step 2. You will be finding rotation factor. U. So rotation factor at the intermediate joints will be finding. So they will be found at the intermediate joints. So you'll make the tabular column joint member relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness, then rotation factor minus 0.5 times distribution factor, that is K divided by summation of K. So here the intermediate joints are two, that is joint B and joint C. Joint B and joint C. With respect to B, the members are BA and BC. BA and BC. With respect to C, the members are CB and CD. CB and CD. Correct? These are the members associated with joint B and joint C, intermediate joint. So relative stiffness with respect to B, the last support is simple support, roller support or hinge support. If it is there, it is 3/4 of I by L. So I is constant. So directly I will write 3/4 of I by L is 4 meters. With respect to B, C is continuous because after this, one more support is there. So if it is continuous, it is I by L, I by phi for BC span I by phi. So like previous problems how we are done. So I am a bit quick in this. So with respect to C to B, it is again continuous because after this one more support is there. So I by L. So again same I by phi. With respect to C, D is fixed. It is I by L, I by 4. So once you simplify this in terms of decimals, add the relative stiffness for BA and BC, similarly CB and CD, you'll be writing it here. So you will be getting at B joint 0.3875i. Similarly here 0.45i. So then relative stiffness you have calculated. Now rotation factor minus 0.5 times k divided by summation of k. So for BA member, k divided by summation of k into minus 0.5. If you do that, you will be getting minus 0.24. So here it will be minus 0.26. Similarly, minus 0.22 here. Here minus 0.28. So you know, one cross check at a joint B and C, ultimately the rotation factor should be 0.5. The summation of this rotation factor at a joint should be minus 0.5. Yes, you are getting. So once you do this, then let us go to the next step, that is rotation moments by iteration table by drawing Carney's boxes. Okay. Yeah, step 3, iteration table or iterative table, you will be doing at drawing Carney's boxes. You will be drawing the Carney's boxes at the intermediate supports or joints, that is at joint B and C. So rest of the things as usual. This is A. Two square boxes to write summation of fixed end moment at a joint and rotation factors. Then this is D, this is C, this is B, and this is A. So before doing the operations, you will check for the last supports. So A is simple support. And D is fixed support. Okay, let me write these values first on top of the horizontal line. So fixed end moments, MFAB, it is minus 103. MFBA, it is minus 23. MFBC, it is minus 24.78. MFCB, 105.42. 105.42. Then MFCD minus 71, and this is 8. Okay, fixed end moments. Then rotation factors at a joint, minus 0.24 for BA, B to A, minus 0.24. This is minus 0.26. So here it is minus 0.22. This is minus 0.28. Okay. So rotation factors for BA, BC, CB, CD. Okay. Then, so now, once you write this, so first you need to check the last supports like previous problem. So we need to do it here, the operation. If the last support is simple, roller or hinged, then moment about that particular support will be zero. So here, yes, there is a simple support, the last support A. So I need to make zero here. I need to release this and 50% of the moment I need to transfer to the joint B. Okay. So here 103 is there minus. So to make 0, I will be adding plus 103. So ultimately it is 0. How much you have added to make 0? So transfer or carry over 50% with the same sign to the next support. So 103 divided by 2. So it will be 51.5. So now here the total moment, it is addition of these two, 51.5 minus 23. So if you do that, you will be getting 28.5. Okay. Then similarly, this minus 24.78 MFBC. Now MFBA, I need to add both the fixed moments and I need to write at the inner square box, that is summation of fixed moment at a joint. My plus 28.5 minus 24.78, you will be getting 3.72. So this is 3.72. So here this value and this value be written here, 105.42 minus 71. So you will be getting 34.42. Yeah, 34.42. Summation of fixed moment at a joint C, MFCB plus MFCD. That is this and this. Once you get this, then we need to start with finding rotation moments. So the rotation moments will be developed at the intermediate supports. That is ultimately you need to find M dash BA, M dash BC, M dash CB and M dash CD, B to A, B to C, C to B, C to D. Okay, you will be finding this. You know, this is trial number one. Okay, this is the iteration what you are going to do it. Since there are two intermediate joints, so redistribution will be taking place, correct? So rotation moment formula, ultimately if I say M dash, this must be equal to rotation factor into summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus summation of far end rotation moments. Correct? This is the formula. So M dash BA, rotation factor, that is minus 0.24. Okay, let me rub this. Remember this formula. Minus 0.24 rotation factor, then summation of fixed moment at a joint, you are writing for B joint, M dash BA or M dash BC, that is for B joint, this is 3.72 plus summation of far end rotation moments. With respect to B, the far ends are A and C. So from A is 0, from C is also 0, this is the trial number 1. Okay, so I'll be writing 0. Similarly here, B to C, rotation factor minus 0.26, fixed moment at a joint 3.72 plus far ends, this and this rotation moments 0. If you simplify this, you will be getting minus 0.89 kilonewton meter, and this is minus 0.96. And this is minus 0.96. Once you get the rotation moments, you will be writing near to the joint and below the line. This is rotation moment for BA. This is for BC. Similarly, now at joint C. So I'll rub this. Rotation moment minus 0.22. Fixed moment at a joint 34.42 plus far end rotation moments. With respect to C, the far ends D, from here it is 0. From here, yes, the value has come from this, that is trial, first trial. So that is minus 0.96. So whatever the value comes here, that you need to consider here. So if you do this, minus 7.36, you will be getting minus 7.36 kilonewton meter. Okay, similarly, M dash C to D rotation factor minus 0.28, fixed moment at a joint 34.42, minus, again same thing, from here 0, from here it is minus 0.96 rotation moments, power end rotation moments. So the value you'll be getting minus 9.36 kilonewton meter. Once you get these values, you'll be writing near to the support. This is minus 7.36. This is minus 9.36. This is trial one. Okay, similarly, trial two. So again, you will continue. Only these value will be changing. Okay, so trial two, again, you will be considering the power end rotation moments. From trial one, whatever you got, you will be go on adding that. So you will continue this procedure until you will be getting subsequent rotation moments, similar values. So as we solved in previous problem, let me write this rotation moments directly. Okay, you do that. In second trial, you will be getting 0.873. This is 0.873. So here it is 10.95. So here it is minus 7.78. M dash CD, it is minus 9.90. Okay, once you get the second trial, first trial value will be striked out. Okay, so again, the values will not be same. We go for another trial iteration. We'll be getting, this is plus 0.97. This is 1.05. 0.95. This is 1.05. This is minus 7.8. This is minus 9.93. Okay, 0.873, 0.97, 1.05, minus 0.78, 9.8, minus 9.93. So again, they are near to the value, but still one more trial if you go. So now they will be same values. 0.98, 1.06, minus 7.8. This is 9.93, minus 9.93. Now third trial and fourth trial values are similar. So now you can stop it here. Okay. So once you get this rotation moments, then you'll be finding the final moments. That is last step. Step number four. So final moments. It is given by fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus 1 times far end rotation moment. Correct? So for example, if you write for AB, MAB, final moment A to B. So fixed end moment and everything already we have made it as 0. So do not apply any formula, directly write it as 0. Important. This above equation is not applicable for this because it is a last support, simple support, moment will be 0 at that particular support. Okay. So next, MBA, fixed moment B to A, I will be considering this, the fixed moment 28.5 plus 2 times near end rotation moment. B to A rating in the same span. So B to A, this is near end and this is far end. So near end, it is 0.98. 2 times 0.98 plus far end rotation moment. With respect to B, the far end is this A, it is 0. If you simplify this, you will be getting 30.46. 30.46 kilonewton meter. Since it is clockwise, that is positive value. Since it is positive value, it is clockwise. Okay. So similarly, if I write for next joint, that is at joint C, or else at joint B only, B to C far right, MBC friction moment minus 24.78 plus 2 times near end rotation moment. So these are the rotation moment. This is near end, this is far end. So it will be like this: near end 2 into 1.06 plus far end, that is minus 9.8. Simplify this, you will be getting minus 30.46 kilonewton meter. Okay, so C to B, MCB, friction moment 105.42 plus 2 times, near end is this, minus 7.8, far end is this, CB, C to B, that is plus 1.06. Simply for this, you'll be getting 90.88. C to B, it is 90.88. So next, C to D, MCD. So friction moment minus 71 plus, this is near end and this is far end. This is near end, 2 times minus 9.93 plus far end, here it is 0. If you simplify this, minus 90.86 kilonewton meter. So at joint B, MBA it is plus 30.46, MBC it is minus 30.46. Same magnitude with opposite direction. Similarly at C, MCB it is 90.88, so MCD it is minus 90.86 or 88. Okay, so finally MDC, MDC friction moment, it is 8 plus 2 times near end rotation moment, that is 0, plus far end rotation moment from here, that is minus 9.93. You will be getting minus 1.93, minus 1.93 kilonewton meter. Okay, so you will be getting all the final support moment values. Okay, so once you get these all values, you will be drawing the actual bend moment diagram, that is the superposition of free bend moment diagram and support moment diagram, and also by engineering mechanics you will be finding the reactions, and ultimately you will be drawing the shear force diagram and then elastic curve, that is deflected shape of the beam. So as we have solved in previous problem, refer that, and you can do it for this problem also. Okay, so next class we'll solve problems on frames. Okay, so frames, when it comes, so we need to divide into non-sway frames and sway frames, because this Kani's method depends on the displacement method. So we should be careful about whether the sway is there in that particular problem or sway is not there. Okay, let us discuss about this in next class. Thank you.